Afternoon, folks. Grandpa Greenwald here. I had a request from one of my subscribers to cook some scotched eggs. Well, I had never heard of scotched eggs. My immediate reply was, I'd have to see if we have some scotch around the house here. When I looked it up and found out what a scotched egg was, soft-boiled egg or a boiled egg, coated in sausage and deep fried, it sounded kind of interesting. So I accepted the challenge. So today we're going to cook just a few scotched eggs. So let's get started. I have the water getting hot here. And what we're going to do, we're going to boil some eggs and we're going to get those peeled and we're going to come back and put all together. So I'm going to adjust these cameras a little bit and I'll jump back in here. We'll get this water boiling and we'll get started. Alrighty, let's get these scotched eggs cooking. I went on the internet to Eggland's Best website, and how does Eggland's Best cook soft-boiled eggs? So what they said, you boil your water and turn it down to a rapid simmer, which is what I have here. I have the temperature set on 250 degrees. We know that water boils at 212. We're going to cool the water down a little bit, setting these eggs in there. So, let's go ahead and get those started. All right, we got them in there. And the water is still boiling okay. All right, we have it for 5 minutes and it depends on how rapidly these are going to start. They're boiling now. They're bubbling pretty good. So we're going to go ahead and give them the 5 minutes, and then we'll take them out and dump them in an ice bath. The hard part is coming up, and that's going to be using these big fatty fingers of mine to peel these eggs, these small eggs. They say large, but I'm going to have to peel these small eggs and keep them whole while I'm doing it. Timer's going off. I'll take these eggs out and just put them right into an ice bath. We want them to stop cooking. Stop cooking immediately. So they're down in the ice bath. And I emptied the water. We're going to use the same pot. We have the eggs in here cooling off. I guess we can go ahead and start peeling these. And again, I should have let these cool a little bit more, but again, I'm not an experienced egg peeler, but I think we can maybe pull it off if we can. Oh boy, I'm feeling it loosen up. I think it helps being down in this water a little bit. Easy, easy, David, easy, easy. I can feel the tenderness in the egg. So it's telling me I have to be real careful, especially when I start coating these babies in. Ah, yeah. I was almost there and I broke the egg. However, I'm not going to worry about it. Maybe we can coat that one anyway. And maybe we'll end up with 3 eggs. Alrighty, we have our eggs peeled. Fortunately, my fat fingers worked a little bit. I didn't break any more. So what I have here is a little bit of flour with a little salt and pepper in it. I'm just gonna just roll the eggs around gently in the pan and put a coating of just coating of this flour on the egg. So anyway, we have a coated, nice coated. Well, you can see the black pepper in there. We'll just get this step done. I had that fire, it got hot, it was bubbling. So I turned it down a little bit to wait on me here. Okay, now I have this broken one. I'm gonna try to also coat that, and I'm gonna have to help it a little bit. And if we're lucky, it's holding together. So let's just let that hold together there. Okay, here comes the delicate part. So we have our homemade breakfast sausage. So what we need to do is smash a piece of sausage out so we can get it big enough to wrap the egg. So this is my first time doing this, so you folks bear with me. We're gonna have to flub through a little bit, but I don't think it's gonna be that big a deal. So we're just gonna start out with the patty maker. Might as well start out with something we know about. Okay, so we have a patty. Wrap my paper, and what I'm gonna do is just start smashing that out. I could have done that by hand. We're gonna get it nice and thin. So we think we have enough there to wrap up an egg. I'm gonna peel this off. And save that for another one. And we have an egg. All right, Brother Bob, this is the test. Wow, nice and thin. I'm just going to pinch off the excess as I go. A little bit of excess there. Wow. Look at that baby. That looks like a piece of sausage with an egg inside. I took this sausage out of the fridge about 45 minutes ago, so we would have it. So it'd be soft enough to work with a little bit. So again, this is our second one here. Pull the top layer off. Nice and easy. Easy, easy, easy. Eggs are about the delicate, most delicate. Look at that baby. Boy, oh boy, that's like a. Come on, fly. Get away from me. I broke it. But I'm not going to let that deter me. Okay. We got a little bit of yolk coming out. I'm not going to worry about that. We're going to put it in an egg wash anyway. Let's just see what happens. There's nothing I can do about it. It leaked. All right, let me dry my hands here. Okay, let's get us another one real quick. Again, we're not worried about that. We're not worried about that little egg yolk. What I am worried about is this fly is wearing me out. But you can't blame him. He's just looking for a meal. Just looking for a meal. So we got one that's perfect. We got one that's a little yolky. Well, another scotched egg ready to go. All righty, we got our four scotched eggs put together. We move on to another step. I'm going to take these babies and I'm just going to put them in the flour again. I'm going to put them in the flour, coat them. Coat them in the flour really nice like that. I'm just going to set them on the cutting board right now. Here's another one. And this is the one where the yolk is running out. It's okay. And I say it's okay because I'm going to cook it anyway. I can't throw the sausage away. That would be a foolish. So we just coat it up real nice like that. Play like it's perfect. Play like we don't really know what's going on there. All right. And set that one down. Brush my hands real quick. All right. Two more steps and we just about got it here. And some breadcrumbs. Used a bunch, way too much I put in there. They're Italian breadcrumbs. That's what I had in the cabinet. That's what we have. Okay, I have some egg wash. What I'm gonna do is pick up my scotched egg. Well, I don't guess it's scotch yet. We're just going to paint that flour. And it's going to get gooey. I'm going to paint that flour all over it. And drop it in the breadcrumbs. We're turning the fire up to 350 degrees. We're going to cook this baby at 350 degrees. Okay. We coat it in the breadcrumb. I'm pushing the breadcrumbs into the sausage as gently as I can. Look at that baby. That's not bad. I don't think it's bad. Looking good to me. This is kind of exciting, cooking something for the first time, knowing you're going to mess it up, knowing you're going to have problems, but you know what we do? We work through them. So we end up with two perfect scotched eggs, and we end up with two with no yolk. Alrighty, let's go ahead and get one of these cooked. I don't know which ones are which, so let's just grab one. And I'm going to go ahead and set that baby down in that 350 degree oil. Alright, let's see what we have here. Oh, let's do this. Let's call it done. Wow, I'm excited. You see me smiling, don't you? All right, let's put this baby again. We don't know which ones are which. Which ones are leaking, which ones are not leaking. Yeah, I'm pretty excited. It came together. We had the problem with the egg leaking out. That's fine. We got 2 out of 4 for the first time. That's not bad at all. This is cooking fine. I don't need a bigger pot. If I could probably put another one down in that pot. But I don't want to. I don't want to crowd it. I just want to sit it in there, let it cook. Well, there's 2 of them. Can't wait to cut into these. All right, I'm going to go ahead and take that one. That sausage was about, I had about 1/4 inch thick, and it's just, it's deep frying. It's not taking long to cook that, to cook the sausage at all. Okay, this is the last one. This is a little small one. I believe this would be a perfect one. Golden brown. Biker Bob, here's to your mom. Here's to your mom, sir. Scotched eggs. Can't wait. Well, folks, I went in and sat down for a couple of minutes and ate that scotched egg. And I got to tell you, it was really amazing to have my sausage where I could taste the flavor of my sausage, the runny, gooey yolk, and the sausage, the crispiness all the way around there, just a really nice crusting around the sausage. It wasn't too done. It was perfectly done. So that's what I would say, just as a recommendation. Don't let them get too done. You know how much sausage you're encasing that egg in. How long does that take to cook a normal piece of, 2 or 3 minutes for a piece of breakfast sausage, especially if you're cooking it, you know, cooking it in the deep fat fryer. So I'm really, really impressed with the flavor of the egg. Will I make it again? I'll probably make it again. That's a real treat to make it during the holidays, maybe. Anyway, again, thanks for coming by. If you liked the video, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, come back and see us again. And again, a shout out to Sir Biker Bob and his mom. We cook for you, Bob. We cook for you.